Welcome to the Totally Awesome Fishing Show. I'm actually on the banks of the Hampshire Avon. I'm float fishing. I'm going to be using a technique. It's a sort of doubled up technique whereby I used to use it years ago. Haven't used it for a long time. I'm going to try and see if it works again. It's for long trotting. Now long trotting, trotting with a float is letting your float here go down with the pace of the current. And obviously you can hold it back, you can speed it up, you can move it around to a certain extent. But basically, you're stuck with the power of that river, of the current there, affecting this float. It's sending the bait pretty well where it wants to go. Anyway, here's what I'm going to be using. This is, I'll have to read this one, folks. It's a Techno Match Super Tip 13-foot carbon rod. Wow, am I impressed with all that gizmo talk? No, it's the 13-foot match rod, end of. But I do like cork handle, and it's got, says everybody emailing in, won't even mention the name, an Aero Perfection, looks like 3500CTM. Look, it's a fixed ball wheel, there's loads on the market. It's seen a bit of wear because it's covered in gunk from the last trip, probably last year, no, my luck. On here, £5 main line, straight through to a bodied Avon float here. Top and bottom, as they call it. I've got a rubber band there. This is a valve rubber that I've cut down a little bit thicker. I'll show you in a minute. I've got my 3BB shot there, which is pretty well what this float takes. It takes a tad more than that, but I've allowed 3BB. And I think it's a number 6 there. And there's the hook, which I've gone a bit big here, size 12 wide gate, because here on the Upper Hampshire Avon, they don't get to see a lot of sort of match fishing and hammer, really. So it should be good. Anyway. I'm going to try and be running down the float as far as I can down the river to cover as much water as I can. Now, my target species is roach, river roach. Not an easy fish to catch. The bigger they get, there's less of them. Up here, I don't suppose there's many people even fish for them, to be honest. But a couple of years ago, Mike had a real clunker, a real nice roach, and it stuck in my mind for a long time. So we used to fish years ago, the premier bait for roach was bread flake. Now, if you pinch a piece of bread flake on the hook, and you're trotting and you have a that might be a bite, or it could be a, what we call a false bite registered by the bottom or a piece of streamer weed, you strike, that's it done. You've got to wind that float all the way back in, bait up again and send it down. Now if you do that a few times, you're going to spook the roach. So what I do is I put maggots on first and I just gently fold a piece of bread flake around the hook. So I'm fishing for roach all the way through the swim. If I get a roach, brilliant. If I don't, I'll get a false bite registered. I strike, I've still got those maggots on the hook. I've still got a chance of running down the end of the swim and getting a fish. So if I use maggots on the hook and a piece of bread flake around those maggots, I don't pinch the bread flake on hard. Now, never pinch bread flake on hard because it goes doughy and you're just never going to strike. Every time you strike, you're going to miss fish because the further downstream you go, there's more stretch in the line, there's more give here in the rod top, so you'll be striking away, you won't even pull the hook through that doughy bread flake. You need to pinch bread flake on so it comes off fairly easily, just enough so it stays on, but obviously you want to be able to strike the hook through it. So my method is put the maggots on first, then fold a piece of bread flake around the hook, trot it down the swim. Should I get a roach, great. If I don't, I get a false bite registered. When I strike, I won't have a bare hook. Now that's twofold. The first bonus is I can keep that float going through, okay? So I still got a chance of picking another fish up at the end of the swim a long way down. The second is all that continually retrieving into rebait will disturb the roach. If it's nice and quiet, they will go off the bite. So I want to go through nice and quietly. So it's a little tip for you. I don't believe anybody has ever done this before, double baiting like this, but I've done it as a few tricks for roach. Let's get cracking, see if it actually works. Now, I'm actually in no rush today because it's very, very bright, but they're giving it clouding over later on. In fact, the haze is starting to come over now, so that's better for me. What I'm going to be using here is my ground bait. Now, people say, roach, little and often, don't overfeed them. I'm thinking, hang on, nobody comes on this part of the river and feeds much anyway that I know of. They're going to eat it, trust me, because I've done it before. And in the river, it's continually going downstream all the time. If they don't bite something, it's gone past their faces. They're never going to get it, are they? It's on the way to the sea. Well, it's on the way to the next fish down, which is going to eat it. So I've got here a ground bait mix of, I suppose, it's not quite 50-50, about 60-40. 60% will say is Bailey's, what they call polo feed. It's a horse feed. It's really good, much cheaper than ground bait, and it's good and it binds together. And about 40% of just regular horse feed, bran, which is unbelievably cheap for a sack. Damp it, do not soak it, damp it, and it will squeeze together as hard as you want. You squeeze it loose, it bursts apart, or you can squeeze it hard like this, and it sinks deeper. Out it goes. It's all going down the river, it's all going to get washed away. So my hook bait, I'm going to be using mostly white maggots. I just like white maggots because, don't forget, I'm going to be using ground bait there, pretty much white. White bread flake on the hook, why not keep to a white maggot? The fish will be used to the fact that white is coming past their face, okay? And the swim we're going to choose is just over there. There's a tree over there. It's creating the main run of the river comes down here. There's some rushes. There's a circulating slack that you probably can see over there. Now that is probably where the roach are. I'm going to start going down the middle of the river first, okay? I'm going to start going down the center, and then I'm going to go, as I've built the feed up, more and more into that slack, because roach are going to be a bit lazy. I mean, a bit like pike, really. They're going to want that slower water, anywhere that's an easy life that you can just move out into the main current, a little bit of delicate feed, and then come back in and sit there again. So that's where I'm going to start trotting, and that's where I'm going to end up. And I feel I could get fish over on that slack. It's so fishy, it's unbelievable. I've got to get started now. It's enough talking. Okay, let's give you an idea on what we're doing here. I'm going to lean my rod on the camera, which nobody else does, so that tells you, yes, I'm fishing alone. Pop down here. I'm going to get the maggots like this, okay? You can see this. Fat end first. Pop the hook through. Roll it around the shank. It's just my way of doing it. It's how I fish. Get my nails. I'm going to pop that fat end over the eye, okay? Then I'm going to put another one rolled around. Fat end first. Roll it around the bend. Then that's completely covered the hook. And I'm going to put a third rod on, which for roach is big, but I'm not going for a small fish. Okay, so that is fine. That's all ready to go. But then I'm going to get a piece of slice of bread. Just break off. I'm going to call it a thumbnail piece. Okay, like that. And I'm just going to fold, open it out a little bit, my bait. My maggots on there, and give that a pinch at the top, generally at the top, so the bend of the hook is clear. That's all ready to go through. I'm going to get it out there, because don't forget the wiggling of the maggots will break that bread apart, but I should get at least one good run through. Got to check the depth a bit, but we'll give it a go. Now, there's other species in here. There is, other than the roach, which I'm after, which are virtually a rarity. Actually, watch me miss a bite. I'll try and talk and fish at the same time. You've got dace. I think you get gudgeon up here as well. You'd most definitely get trout, both brown and rainbow. And I'm sure at some stage during the day I'm going to get a trout here. Probably early on, because they tend to get pretty aggressive on the feed first. So I'm getting down the middle of the river. One of the guys told me there's perch in here, which I didn't know before. There are a few pike in here, not many. Grayling, really good grayling. Less likely to take the bread, I find, more likely to take the maggots. But I'm going down the bottom of the swim now, the float's running through. I've still got my bread on, I haven't had to strike, so I can tell my bait is set above any weed there. Of course, rivers are undulating, they go up and down, so you know there can be stream of weed further down. I've been fishing for 2 years, but I'm in the main flow at the moment, just going round the main flow. Oh, just I've just seen a big swirl upstream from the float. Now I'm going to have to wind in now, and just so I can show you this, there you go. I've been through that entire swim with bread, but I went even further down and I've got maggots on the hook still. So that shows you, a fold of bread around the maggots lets you go through. You can have roach and chub, especially love a nice piece of bread flake. Works very, very well, but you don't keep whipping the bait up and down all the time like you would normally if you were fishing punch bread or just straight bread flake. Every time you go through, you miss a bite, or you get, bam, you strike, the bread's gone. This way, no, the bread's gone, but the maggots are still on there. That's a totally awesome fishing tip I bet a lot of guys didn't know about. Fish on, people. Not a big fish, not a big fish at all. Feels grayling. That's what I'm going to say. Oh, no. Oh, target species, third trot down.
There we go.
There we go, people. Beautiful, beautiful avian roach. Let me just untangle them and show them to you. Now, don't get tangled. We don't want any tangling. Don't want any tangling. It's actually come off the hook there. Look. How annoying is that? Pop it through, and there we go. That is what I came for. Third trot down. I missed him. I had a little bump on the bread, and I think they knocked that off, and I've got the maggots there. So it just goes to show you that it does work. Doubling those baits up like that. Just get the hook out for you, chappy. There you go. Don't want to drop him. What a neat little chap. With his little pretty eye. Look at his eye, Jim. Lovely fish. Target species. I'm going to get some more feed in. And he was just on the edge of the slack. So that tells me where the feed's been going. Now I'm going to concentrate on that line. Add a little bit more. Put him back. Big dice, people, big dice. Let's grab the net. That's a spanking fish for a dace. Now, I have had some absolute monsters up here, and I brought with me some special scales. I'm actually going to weigh that. I think that's better than 6 ounces, that one, and I'm going to put it in a plastic bag. Let's check out and just see how big this one is. It's a chunker. It's a ka-chunker. Oh, my word. My word, people. Don't tell me that. It's a small dace. It would be absolutely sacrilege to lose a fish like that to a pike. It's a fat, fat one. That's over 8 ounces, that dace. I mean, I don't want to drop it. Come on, chappy. Be famous on YouTube. Look at the size of that. Let's get him in this bag. I've already put water in the bottom of the bag and then registered the scales. Because you've actually got little zero bits here as well. I've seen the sunlight. 275 grams. 275 grams. Dear God alive, what's that in English? Does anybody out there know what 275 grams is? I say that fish is getting up towards half a pound. Look at the size of it. It is gargantuan. Let's get it back, see if we can get some more. Tell you what, two fish like that, that's made my day already. And folding that bread around, that was 100% on bread, by the way. That float barely traveled to the swim, and it was slack anyway. So you can see it, there it is again, double baited. Does anybody else do it? I think not. I think Graham might be the first to tell you all about it. Old school methods still work. I'll tell you what else is going to move in. I feel if they're on the bite like that, I feel it won't take long for some of those trout, rainbows, browns, they're going to move in on me. Don't know about the grayling. I probably need straight maggots, but I'm going to try and catch a big roach, but who knows? What a great dace. Oh, what a great dace fishing. Oh, I'll kill myself. Big fish here, guys, big fish. Just as soon as the float hit, gone on Bredis. I don't think this is a trout. Really, really worried about this. I bumped two other fish off. I love it when you see the float cutting through the water, but it's heart-stopping when you don't know what the species is. It does not feel trouty. It's scaring me. Oh, come on. Oh, I don't know, maybe it took off there, maybe it's a trout. If this one's a dace, my spring balance and plastic bag aren't big enough. Going. I might have to go downstream. He's stripping me out here, guys. I don't have to go downstream here. I'm going to have to net him. I can. Down there somewhere. I'm going to get him in a bit of slack. What is this thing? Big rainbow. Absolutely ridiculous. That match was in full power, Ben. Can't give it any more. It's just the current as well. The reason I keep my rod low is I'm trying to turn it over and bring him into the slack here and then bring the rod back and net him down here somewhere. But it's timing when you're going to lift him. Come on, fish. Man alive. Ridiculous. The net's folded in itself. I'm just never supposed to catch this fish. Come on, come on. Finally, finally, success with a very, very large, I'd like to say dace, but it's a rainbow trout. Let me just show you this kitty. Look at that. About 4 pounds, I would guess. No wonder I had so much trouble on a match rod. Full tail, lovely fish. He's absolutely mullered. The bread, the maggots, he's not fussy. It's going down the hatch. Fantastic looking fish. Look at that. Well, there we go, folks. Another roach. I must have had about 8 rainbows now, small ones, a bit bigger than this. They seem to have moved it right in on the ground bait, but by striking the bread off, or missing the bite, or getting the trout, I can let them run farther down, let the float go through to swim, and I can actually pick these roach up further down the back. So at the moment, it's all looking good. Wow, what a session. Another species to show you. This time, the lady of the stream, the grayling. Brilliant fishing, all on a float, ground bait, bran, horse feed, spread, maggots. How basic can you get? And look at that fish. Notice the little dots underneath it on their throat. Can you see those black marks? Lovely little grayling. Can't be many species left in here for me to catch now. I like one of those big roach. Nice fish, let's get it back. The more I'm feeding, the more I'm catching. All that little and often, I think it's a load of rubbish. a chunk, ladies, another huge river rainbow. I've had about 15 smaller ones. Come up here and have a look. Show the folks at YouTube what you look like. Look at that one, people. Beautiful fish, beautiful tail. What a scrap. Let's get it back. I've also had a few other grayling as well, but the roach aren't even getting a look in, unfortunately. There he is. What a beauty. He said, nearly stepping on his fishing rod. Close to 3, I would guess. Another little tip. When you've got fish action fast, if you don't use forceps, just keep a plastic disgorger like the Matchman do behind your ear and you're all ready to get that hook out quickly. Can't tell you the number of times I used to go digging and searching around. I couldn't find the disgorger anywhere. Look at the Matchman, where do they have it? Close to hand, behind their ear. On the camera as well, guys. What is this one? Small rainbow. This is almost a swinger. Ooh, there he is. About as big as that dace. But notice these are much darker. These are escapees, I think, from a fish farm nearby. There he is. And they are, I want to say, they're giving me some sport, but I'm here for the roach. I see enough trout on the fly. The thing is, the cloud cover's now coming over, and that's really bringing the fish on the bite. In the winter when it's bright, it can be a bit tough, but a little bit of haze over the top of it like this. I can't talk and look at the same time. I'm just thinking, 1.5 pound roach has got my name on it somewhere. If I can fight my way through the trout. Oh, what is this? My word alive. That float sunk, disappeared, and was on the way to Australia. It's better not be a roach, that's all I know. It's just a big fish if it is. I fear the trout have mullered me now. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, this could be it, guys. Oh, no, please don't come off. Oh, it's unbelievable. Unbelievable river roach. Please don't come off. I thought it was a trout. Oh, it's a spanking fish. Oh, I'm just not going to screw around. I'm going for it straight away. First shot. Oh, yes. Get in. Totally awesome. Man alive, I thought. My chance. Please. This is what you come. Oh, so pleased. I cannot tell you. What an animal. Oh, look at this one. Look at this one, people. What a specimen. People say, don't get excited. Look, I catch marlin, big sharks. Yeah. That's a big roach. That is a big roach in the river. Probably never, ever been caught before. And he has mullered that bait, which is where this comes in. Slide it down the line, onto the hook, and you just pop it out. Oh, I can't believe that. What a fish to catch. What a, there's a hook, there's a bait. Oh, do you know what? 1.5 pounds of anybody's money. Where's that bag? 765. That's well over a pound, I know. Well, what a fish. What a result, I can't tell you. I'm pleased to catch that. Look at it. Let's get him in the water. I can't put the magus on, my hands are still shaking. What a fish. And there's no question, you saw casting out there. That had to be the bread, Hadn't gone down in the current, hadn't gone far enough down to even soak off. And what am I gonna do? Is gonna get another piece of bread out there. I honest to God thought that was yet another rainbow trout. That is the biggest roach that I've ever caught on camera, striking the fish, casting out, striking on the fish. That was brilliant. So is this tangle. This is brilliant. Why do you always get tangles when you want to get in the water really quickly, really quickly? And then you get even worse of a tangle because you're rushing, aren't you? 60 plus and I'm still rushing with excitement. Set. Oh, now there's another tangle. Okay. Lucky. Bridge still on there. Round the back of the reel. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Here we go, here we go, here we go. What a cast. It deserves a medal, folks. Now, let's see if that... Do you know, I had a feeling those roaches were there, but I thought the trout moved in so much that I've got no... Don't look. Oh, no, don't worry. It's a trout. There's a lovely bonny wee laddie. Look at him. Leaping and jumping all around, so he is. If he's not careful, he'll leap and jump on the way to the frying pan. This gorger, man. I feel like I'm a match fisherman now, I'm on fire. Oh yeah, you're gonna want to see this one as well, folks. Another prime Avon dace. Let's have a look at this one, look. There's some big, big dace in this stretch. Look at the size of this one, people. Am I having a day to remember or what? That looks like a small chub to me. Absolutely huge, huge, chunking great big dace. Years ago, I used to use dace as a prime bait for pike. I can't bring myself to use them, really. There's no way in the world I'd ever use a prime dace like this for a pike lay bait. No, it's just not going to happen. I've got to put them back. They're just under so much threat from everything. Otters, cormorants, people, me. Get this hooked properly. I took it out and got it back even further. Got him. There we go. What a specimen. Straight back. People, I'm loaded up on something here. It's a trout, but it doesn't look a rainbow. And boy, has it got some power. It's a lot more silver. I can see the shape of it under the water. But I just can't for the life of me actually make out what it is. I don't know if it's a brown. I don't even know if it's a salmon. Whatever it is, it's not supposed to be caught in a match rod. Tell you what, it looks awfully like a salmon to me. It looks awfully like a salmon. It's just going unbelievably like a train. It's so silver. Maybe it's a brownie. It's absolutely piling. The pressure on this rod does not want to give up. See, the bend in this rod is unbelievable. Got him. It's just a really big silver rainbow trout. Oh, my word. What a lump. Let me show you. I thought it was a bay salmon. Look at that one, people. No wonder I had a fight on it with a tail like that. And he was so silver. That's what threw me up. I just looked at it and I thought, is that a big brown? Is it a small salmon? What is it? What an unbelievable. Look at it. It's unbelievable. Oh, I'm all of a quiver again. I've only just cut over that roach. What is this one? Oh, yes. A result. A nice big grayling. I better take it easy on this one. Another thing you've got to watch is grayling. You can bump them, what we call bump them. The hook just pops out their mouth. They've got a hard bone edge around the outside of their lip. We might lose this fish, but it's a nice one. Oh, here you come. Come and see the folks at YouTube. There we go, big grayling. Look at that lovely big fin on it. I guess a fish, probably shading pound and a half. Might be going up around the pound and a half there, trying to get the fin up for you. There we go. What a nice one. Do you know, I thought it was yet another big trout. And how many trout have I had? I would say somewhere over 30. Beautiful fish, let's get it back. I'm sorry people, but this is the dace to end all dace. What do you think? Got to be worth putting in the bag. It's got to be around about 10 ounces at least. Look at it, magnificent fish. Here's another totally awesome tip. I can't take any more on that swim, I've got to move. I'm exhausted, my elbow's killing me. More than 50 fish so far. If you've got three swims in a row that you want a long trot down, always make sure you start at the top swim first. That way, any food missed by that swim's fish in the middle and the lower swims are sure to intercept it. That's just what I've done here. I'm just going to have a last minute, half hour. I think I've come down here for a rest actually. Right down the middle swim I've done, and I'm coming down to the bottom area, then that's me for the day. But hopefully it won't take a lot of feed to get these fish going. Now, another little tip, you can actually get these worn, these little valve rubbers there. It'll pay you to get one a little bit longer or to change it once in a while, because when you strike, it can slip and you can lose your depth. I can see immediately I've lost my depth, I can guess it there. But just a tip, I'm not going to change it now because it won't be here for very long, but just change that and make it a little bit longer, that valve rubber, and then it's tighter and it shouldn't slip when you strike. Railing written all over it, folks. So at the back, there's a raft of weed that's, maybe it's a trout. It's got a raft of weed here that's all been caught up in the rubbish. It is in fact a small, feisty, jumping rainbow trout. What can I say, folks? I came down this swim for a rest. But you can see there, I don't know what this is. Man, it looks like a big grayling. By coming downstream, all the food I've been throwing in, all that bread, everything has been coming down here. Bran, all the ground bait mix, all the loose maggots, all coming down. The fish down here, they've probably been feeding for the last 3 hours. It's a nice grayling. And yes, where's the net? Folks, a nice grayling, all fresh and wiggling with its lovely fin up. They do make a pretty picture, there's no question of that. Lovely looking fish here. Let's get it back, let's hope. Don't think I'll get the roach here, to be honest, the pace is a little bit too much. But let's hope I get a bit of a rest from the trout and get some really pretty fish like this. Tell you what, it's a good job there's some benches around to sit on, because this is the first time I've sat down all day. It's been non-stop action. My mistake, I didn't bring enough bread with me, so I'm getting mullered by the trout, but I've had some fantastic fish, and I think you'll agree. Match rod, just a regular Avon float rod. Avon float there, bodied Avon float. Just keep that feed. I've done half a bucket of baits gone in, hasn't even scratched the surface, to be honest. I fished two swims, that's all I fished. And sun's going down, fantastic, beautiful late winter's evening. If you get the chance, get out there, try that double baiting by folding a piece of bread around the maggots, could even be worms as well. But you saw what I caught, monster dace, and that roach, absolutely, that's the icing on the cake for me. That is what fishing the Hampshire Avon is all about. So thanks for watching the Totally Awesome Fishing Show. If you get bored, skip over to our sister channel, the Totally Awesome Outdoors Show. There's free films to watch on there as well. Until next time, I've got to keep moving. So beautiful here, I'm just going to keep fishing otherwise.